Hello and welcome to In-Depth, the show where we bring you a detailed analysis on a subject of current significance. I am Tina Jha. This month marks a significant milestone in the evolution of the web. The blogosphere that has today become a valuable source of information and insight is celebrating its 25th year of existence. It is believed that the first serious blog appeared this month 25 years ago. It was called Scripting News, and the URL was scripting.com. The author of the software, Dave Viner, has updated it every day since 1994. And since then, blogging has come a long way. Today, it is a vital part of our mainstream online culture. Practically everyone reads blogs now, whether they are news blogs, subject-based blogs, blogs related to one's work or hobbies, or blogs purely for entertainment. In a way, blogging has come to be one of the predominant forms of user-generated content on the web. And their popularity and usage has only grown with the advent of micro-blogging sites and also the emergence of vlogs and podcasts. Today on the show, we trace the journey of blogging, we explore how blogs became so popular, and how they influence people, society, media, as well as the politics. So let's first tell you how blogging started and some interesting people behind it. In this report, let's trace the journey of how blogging became popular since its emergence 25 years ago. At first, there were personal diaries and journals, and then came blogging. Blogging started as a way to express feelings and catalog thoughts. But over the years, they evolved as a marketing tool to build brands, attract clients, provide news and interesting facts all at the same time. Today, blogging is an integral part of online culture.
Initially, internet came up in the year mid-1990s and started catching pace slowly. Internet used to be slow and internet was very costly. So the amount of data which internet could give to a user at in a unit time or a unit cost was very low. So it started off with something called blogging. Now blogging means just expressing what you feel on usually a free channel where anybody can read it. They could range from user experiences to small from cooking to reviews to how someone went through an experience. Everything was contained in a blogging. Blogging was usually a very personal thing.
Online blogging is traced to the 1990s when a 19-year-old college student, Justin Hall, created the first blog, Links.net. According to Hall, he created the site to get his writings online. The site was very simple and contained a collection of links that Justin found interesting while browsing the web, along with a couple of photographs. At that time, they weren't called blogs. Hall just referred to as his personal homepage. But the site earned him the title Founding Father of Personal Bloggers. In 1997, John Barja coined the term weblog to describe a log of his internet activity. He created the term to reflect the process of logging the web as he browsed. A year later, a first blog was published on an established news site. Weather reporter Jonathan Duke blogged Hurricane Bonnie for the Charlotte Observer. The next few years saw the emergence of the first blogging platforms like Open Diary, Shanga, LiveJournal, and Blogger. LiveJournal was founded by Brad Fitzpatrick to keep in touch with his high school friends. Blogger was founded by Pyra Labs as a commercial platform and later acquired by Google, which made it free and available to everyone. Blogger is largely responsible for bringing blogging to the mainstream. In 1999, weblog was shortened to blog by programmer Peter Merholz. The original blogs were updated manually, often linked from a central homepage or archive.
In the 1990s, with some of the sites, which one of them was called Blogspot, back then it used to be very popular. There were sites which were social media sites of those times, which were also quite popular. Things like MySpace and so on. Orkut used to be there, where people used to put not very long posts, but you could always put, you know, a decent post. Orkut became sort of the predecessor to Facebook. It gave people a free way to express what they feel. So a lot of people who wanted to write something and could not write it in a newspaper or could not put it as a book because those are expensive items and require a very high degree of skill and reputation, they started their career as writers being a blogger.
The beginning of the new millennium brought about another blogging platform in the year 2001. The platform was Movable Type that was released as a self-hosted platform for bloggers. 2002 marked the launch of Technorati, the first blog search engine. WordPress was started in 2003, though parts of its development date back to 2001. Audio Blogger, the first major podcasting service, was founded in 2003. The first video blog started in the year 2004, more than a year before YouTube was founded. At the same time, Blogads, the first ad network, was launched to connect advertisers and publishers. Besides a number of political blogs and blogs featuring in-depth tutorials and guides, also called meta blogs, also cropped up during this period. By the mid-2000s, blogs had reached the mainstream. According to Technorati's State of the Blogosphere report, there were 23 blogs on the internet in the year 1999. By mid-2006, the number had crossed 50 million, and by 2010, there were 152 million active blogs. As the blogosphere continued to grow, a different form of blogging appeared called microblogging. It was marked by the launch of Twitter in 2006. Soon, Twitter spun off into its own company and gained popularity. Today, the platform boasts around 6,000 tweets being sent out every second. In the year 2007, Tumblr launched as the first official microblogging platform. It encouraged users to post brief content as a way of allowing those who do not have the time to publish long-form content and still want to be heard. Blogs and podcasts followed next. They have taken on a bigger role in the blogosphere, with many bloggers opting to primarily use multimedia content. With the rise of microblogging platforms and the maturing of established blogging software, communication today has become easier than ever before. Bureau Report, Rajya Sabha TV.
When creating a blog, it's important to choose the right type of blog to show its purpose and also how it goes about reaching its goals. In our next report, we'll take a look at the types of blogs and how social media platforms and websites are slowly replacing blogging.
The blogging world has different kinds of blogs and bloggers to reach specific goals. Different types of blogs cover a wide range of topics, interests, and audiences. One of the most popular types of blogs are the personal blogs. It is an ongoing online diary or commentary written by an individual rather than a corporation or organization. While the vast majority of personal blogs attract very few readers, a few personal blogs have become popular, to the point that they attract lucrative advertising sponsorship. Collaborative blogs or group blogs have posts written and published by more than one author. A majority of high-profile collaborative blogs are based around a single uniting theme like politics, technology, or advocacy. Food blogs are another popular type. They attract readers interested in recipes, healthy eating, and other food-related stories. Travel blogs help people looking for travel tips and destination guides, while lifestyle blogs have a variety of readers interested in topics ranging from culture, arts, local news, and politics. They can also happen to be the most popular type of blogs one can find online. Political blogs cover news on politics, analysis of political news, and can quickly build a very large engaging audience. Then there are reverse or guest host blogs, where the content is supplied by the public. A reverse blog has a team that moderates posts, prevents unpleasant interactions, and promotes slow topics for greater interactivity. Besides these, there are parenting blogs, health blogs, fashion blogs, beauty blogs, lifestyle blogs, sports blogs, among others.
Blogging means just expressing what you feel on a usually a free channel where anybody can read it. they could range from user experiences to small from cooking to reviews to how someone went through an experience. Everything was contained in a blogging. Blogging was usually a very personal thing. So people used to read about each other.
Over the last few years, blogging has been overshadowed by social media, by Facebook, YouTube and Twitter in particular. Microblogging is the practice of posting small pieces of digital content that could be text, pictures, links, short videos or other media on the internet. Besides this, social networking sites have made it even easier for people to express themselves. Facebook, the social media giant, has since arrived on the scene and developed into a multimedia-rich social networking portal where you can invite all your friends and share your story with minimal friction. Bureau Report, Rajya Sabha TV.
Time for a short break on the program, but when we return, we'll talk about video blogging. Do stay with us. Welcome back. You're watching In Depth. Video blogs, also called vlogs, are a unique way for people to reach out to others in a unique way. In recent years, blogging has evolved into a giant community on social media where people release information about anything that they want. And over the years, vlogging has become a mix of blogging and streaming. Here's a detailed report on vlogging and how it became a 21st century trend.
Vlog derives from video log or video blog, referring to blogs where most or all of the content is in video form. Vlog entries often combine embedded videos or a video link with supporting text, images, and other metadata. Entries can be recorded in one take or cut into multiple parts. Vlog is a popular category on the video sharing platform YouTube. Alternatively, it can also be understood as a form of web television. A vlog is sometimes also called a videocast or vodcast. Motor vlogs are vlogs made while riding a motorcycle.
And blogging, which used to be a low data, a low storage item, has been replaced by video logging, which is called video log or vlogging in popular language. And 2005 onwards, a lot of users, usually young age group users, started their blogs as videos, and which is now called vlogging. Vlogging really caught attention around 2012, when some very popular vloggers started making a lot of money and they got a lot of subscribers. So that is when vlogging really took off. And today I think vlogging has totally beaten blogging. Even popular sites like social media sites like Facebook are encouraging people to put in more and more videos.
New York-based artist John Nelson Sullivan was known for recording videos around New York City and South Carolina in a vlog-like style back in the 1980s. On January 2, 2000, Adam Contreras posted a video alongside a blog entry aimed at informing his friends and family of his cross-country move to Los Angeles in pursuit of show business, marking the first post on what would later become the longest-running video blog in history. In recent years, vlogging has evolved into a giant community on social media where people can release any information that they want. Vlogs saw a pronounced increase in popularity around the year 2004. One of the most popular vlogs, Rocket Boom, was a daily news broadcast produced by Andrew Barron. These early vlogs set an important precedent by acclimatizing audiences to follow individual creators and influencers. In 2005, vlogging took a leap forward with the launch of YouTube, a free, searchable video hosting platform available for anyone to take advantage of. While YouTube's inception represented a fundamental step in vlogging development, vlog creation at this point was largely sporadic and lower in quality, featuring few edits. By July 2006, YouTube had become the fifth most popular web destination with 100 million videos viewed daily and 65,000 new uploads per day. The Yahoo video blogging group also saw its membership increase dramatically by August 2005.
From 2012 to 2016, worldwide digital video viewers have grown from 372 million to nearly 700 million, an increase of 87%. Digital video time spent has also risen sharply by 120%, from 26 minutes per day to nearly an hour, fueled largely by smartphones, which have overtaken desktop viewing. Charles Trippi of the Internet Killed Television YouTube channel currently holds the Guinness World Record for the most consecutive daily personal video blogs posted on YouTube, with over 3,000 consecutive videos. As smartphone technology progressed, in particular smartphone camera advancements, vloggers began to forego video camera equipment and simply used their smartphones. Mobile technology has not only facilitated vlogging, but has also proved to be the ideal platform for consuming bite-sized chunks of content. Globally, 44% of all internet users watch a vlog each month. As a result, vlogging today is big business. With rapidly changing technology, vloggers or bloggers must follow a certain code of conduct while expressing their views. An online content creator is an important part of the wider public knowledge creation and discussion. This role carries with it a responsibility to be fair, honest and respectful, not only toward your fellow members of society, but also towards facts. The content creator must realize that they must present fact as fact and opinion as opinion. While freedom of speech, information, publication and expression are basic elements of a democracy and a content creator can exercise his or her right, online content creators should understand their responsibility and handle issues with sensitivity. With inputs from Leena Sharma, Bureau Report, Rajya Sabha TV.
Over the last two decades, blogging has reshaped the notion of how content is created and information disseminated. In fact, it has changed the rules governing the ways that news is reported. From open societies to closed ones, blogging has been in the forefront of citizens' journalism ventures. It has made information more accessible, conversational, and of course, available from more diverse sources.
From calling out politicians on false statements to exposing factual errors and outright fake news, bloggers have had the biggest impact on mainstream media and political events. In 2004, bloggers exposed documents about President Bush's military service record as forgeries. It forced a prominent media house to apologize for its faulty reporting. Incidents like these have cemented the acceptance of blogs as a credible medium of news dissemination. In recent years, bloggers have often brought key information to light and mainstream media has followed their lead. Bloggers have allowed the people access to more diverse, credible and culturally relevant information sources. They have also provided impetus to citizen journalism on the internet, especially in countries where traditional media suffers from official censorship or outright authoritarian rulers. Online citizen journalism, in the form of blogs, video blogs, vlogs, has challenged the ability of states to control the flow of information.
Distinctively has at least three issues. First is the fact that there is, because it becomes popular very soon, a popular blogger would, if he puts a new video, within a day, he will have close to a million, 5 million, 10 million views. Which means that if anything is false, it has already reached a crore plus people within a day before you can actually catch hold of it. And the legal system across the world is extremely loose when it and unprepared compared to, you know, how do you handle mainstream media versus how do you handle a blogger. So it's very difficult. So the accountability is very low.
In the past, it has triggered movements like the Arab Spring, and today, virtually no popular mobilization takes place without it. It provides a more realistic view of the world than the traditional media. But there is a downside as well. The growing attention paid to blogs by journalists and human rights organizations has made them a double-edged sword.
We see in journalism, one of the new concepts which has come up is mobile journalism, where a mobile phone and a single user who's interviewing also and shooting also, that mobile journalism is an upcoming trend. It significantly cuts down the cost, and B, it's very easy to do given the mobile phones have become extremely efficient in terms of processing, in terms of camera work, in terms of editing. So a lot of journalism which you see today, as you all know, is shot from a mobile phone and not just a traditional camera. The other thing is that it has also made accessibility in small remote places possible, where big cameras, big crews can't go. You can have a stringer, a freelance journalist who can use a mobile phone and do a sort of a citizen journalism, which is also becoming extremely important. A lot of your news item today content comes from people who are present there with a mobile phone. So every citizen has become and has a voice now, has a democratic voice, which he can express or she can express using just a mobile phone and becoming a sort of a journalist on ground.
While blogs and vlogs provide alternative information, they are also sources of much unverified information. Despite rules being framed for bloggers, blogs relating to public figure have often been found to guilty of defamation. Blogs and vlogs also face allegations of misuse by political parties. Bureau Report, Rajya Sabha TV.
And that's it from us today in depth. We'll be back same time tomorrow now with a focus on some other subject. In case you missed the television broadcast of our program, you can also watch it online on YouTube and Twitter, the link for which is given below on your screens. And of course, you can also send in your feedback and suggestions about our program. Thank you very much for your time.